guys, Yvette here, and I am the Witch of Willow Creek. Welcome to my channel. And today's video is a look at the week ahead. I did do one for a self-care Valentine's Day video reading. So this is going to be for the rest of the week, okay? So be for the rest of the week, and you can combine it with the rest that with the video that is going to come up Monday. But and usually my week ahead scroll up on Monday, but Valentine's Day is a Monday, so we're going to go ahead and just put this out Sunday. So I normally do my reading the night before I upload it. So I'm doing this in the afternoon, obviously, because people are just rude, living their lives like, what the hell? Don't they know I'm doing a video? Anywho's. This is the look at the week ahead, and let's see what the week ahead has in store for us. I hope everybody had a wonderful week. I hope everyone has a wonderful Valentine's Day, and if you ain't got nobody, don't worry about it. As long as you're happy with yourself and you treat yourself for Valentine's Day. None of this business of having to have somebody with you. Like, don't let people make you feel guilty about not having somebody. It's all right if you don't. Okay, so we've got the Three of Cups and the Queen of Pentacles. So we got the Queen of Pentacles, and yes, look at you. You don't give a shit. You don't give a shit what anybody's thinking about you. Your emotions are just like, what? See that look on her face? Look at that look on her face. She's like, fuck you. You got somebody sitting there telling you, oh, shouldn't you be married by now? Shouldn't you have kids by now? This and that. I look at that look on her face. She's like, whatever, fucker. I'm happy by myself. You're the one struggling with your family and kids. I ain't got to worry about that shit right now. And you're getting your finances, you're getting your finances together. You're on the top of your game and trying to get your shit together, worrying about yourself without having to worry about somebody else's problems and people bringing more things to your table, right? Jesus, if you're single, that is your situation. But if you're in a relationship, you've had enough of their bullshit. You're like, I got my own fucking money. I don't have to sit around and deal with your ass. All right? Like, they have no idea what they got, right? And you're looking at them like, yeah, you have no idea. You have no idea. You think you're the end all and be all. But I can do without you. We've got the Lovers and the Eight of Swords. And here's the thing. That's right. You can do without them. Right? I mean, because look at you. You're self-assured. You know what you want. You know what you're doing. And sometimes you got these people who are like, well, you know what? I'm the one that's the breadwinner. This and that. You know what? Yeah, no, no. Because you know that you can do it on your own. What they give you, what you get from them, and what you give to them, there is no price. If that makes any sense. Like, The other person usually likes to put a financial number on what they do, on their worth. But the truth is that especially with stay-at-home relationships, like stay-at-home moms and dads or whatnot, they give a lot of themselves to keep the house going, to deal with the children, to do the groceries. I mean, they do everything else that the other person's not doing. Like the other person goes to work, does what they need to do at work and comes back. But the people who stay at home, they're never off. They work 24/7. They get a break from their job to come home. Now, I mean, if this is a verbal situation, contract that you have with each other, then that's a verbal contract you have with each other. But if it's not, if you were at work and you're working, you're doing your job or whatnot, right? You're earning your money. You're not married. You come home. Who has to do the laundry? Who has to do the grocery shopping? Who has to do the cooking? You still have to do the laundry. So you're still working when you get home, right? If you're a single parent, you're still working and dealing with the kids when you get home. So when you're a couple, you should actually pull in together, because you're gonna have to fucking do it anyway if you're together or if you're single or not. Right? So we need to stop belittling these parents who are at home taking care of what they need to be taken care of, because they're doing their job. I know. I was a stay-at-home mom. And I mean, 24/7. 24/7. Still, like, it never ends. So, yeah. And we see it as, you go to work, yes, you don't have to deal with the stress of the home or whatnot. And that's a break from the house responsibilities. You're technically getting a break from what's happening at home, right? And then you have to deal with it when you get home. And you gotta understand that sometimes this is about people who can easily leave the shit at home and go out and start and their work day. Because a lot of people, majority of people, don't leave their shit at home. Evident by the customer service you get when you go to a store and they bitch you out because they're having a bad day. Anywho's, guys. All this to say is that this week you are feeling yourself. You know what you want. You know your worth. And you're not bound to nobody's expectations. That is this week, right? Now let's get an affirmation card. Oh, actually, let's get an oracle, because that's what we do next is the oracle. So I have some sugar and I'm paying for it, guys. I feel like crap. Like, I literally feel sick. And before you say, and I need to get checked for diabetes, I've already been checked. I don't have it. But sugar, for some reason, makes me sick. Maybe I'm allergic to sugar. I don't know. But only some sugars I'm okay with. I mean, not every sugar, but I can, there's some sweets that I can have that don't make me sick at all. And then there are some others that are just like, ugh. Okay. What else do we need to know? What else do we need to know about next week? These cards are always so sticky because they're shiny. What else do we need to know about next week? Coming to life. Ah, that's exactly what's happening here. For some of y'all, this is just dawning on you and you're like, wait, what? Yeah, I am worth more than what they think I'm worth. And my feelings matter. And what I, you know, what I feel matters, what I want matters. You are waking up. Let's get an affirmation card. If you ever want to see a walkthrough of any of the decks that I have, any of these cards, any of the cards that I'm using, there's always, I have a walkthrough for every deck that I have. I have it in a playlist. I got some of them are called, some of them are walkthroughs, and some of them are with flip throughs, you know, so. They're all in there. Okay. Let's get affirmation new. Let's get an affirmation for next week. If y'all like this affirmation deck, the link is down below. She's having a dance sale. So, you can go check that out. that was too many cards falling out of my hand. We just need one affirmation. That's where I think a bunch of kids live, a bunch of teenagers live in this apartment complex. I guarantee somebody my age is not running around with the beatboxing. I am confident. That's exactly what you see right there, confidence. I am confident. So, you can screenshot that for the rest of the week. You can look at it and tell yourself, I am confident. I can do this. I am confident. Alrighty, guys. That was a look of... the rest of the week, next week, and I hope everybody has a wonderful Valentine's Day, and I will talk to y'all next time. Bye, guys.